So what's it cost to get rid of an Australian Prime Minister? How much do you reckon it cost to get rid of ScoMo? Well, we know how much it cost to get rid of Kevin Rudd. $22 million. It cost $22 million to get rid of Kevin Rudd. We know that because Rudd wanted to change the tax regime during the super boom to make big companies pay tax for extracting minerals from Australian soils. So the Minerals Council, which is the coal peak body, they're like the PR mob for coal and other minerals. They just started an advertising campaign. $22 million they spent on relentless ad campaigning against the government on TV and radio, etc. A few months later, Kevin Rudd was gone. Julia Gillard was there. They backtracked on the mining tax, and that's history.
The government has abandoned its super profits tax and come up with a new watered-down minerals tax. Not everyone's happy, but the three biggest mining companies are on board, and threats they made to jobs and investments are already being cancelled.
The big mining tax they wanted to bring in, which would have helped Australia preserve some of this wealth instead of seeing it funneled overseas, it was gone. The power of the Minerals Council of Australia is central. It's so central that these guys, two of them, two ex-Minerals Council executives, John Kunkel, former Minerals Council deputy chair, he is now the Prime Minister's chief of staff. The other guy is Brendan Pearson, his trade advisor. And Pearson was head of the Minerals Council. But these are the guys with the whispers in the Prime Minister's ear every day that transcend into the messaging to the Canberra bubble media people from News and Nine and etc. that creates the agenda for morning television and radio. It all comes out of the Prime Minister's office, the Treasurer's office, and the Minerals Council is there. It is central, the coal peak body in Australia. Now these guys are a very cherished position. Indeed, they contribute. They are actually members of both political parties. They're members of both political parties. And we know that because reporter Stephanie Tran has done some excellent work finding out which top Australian corporations are actual members of the two major political parties. And the Minerals Council is there. But it gets a little cherry on top. It's got a $3.6 million grant. It's got a contract for education. The Minerals Council, education contract, gets money back, coming back the other way.
Government buildings are so easy to rob. You can walk in here in broad daylight, take everything, and no one even says anything.
How's it going? I just need this team.
There is the actual sheer physical proximity of these people. If you're at Parliament House and you walk down the hill, one of the first buildings, it may be indeed the first building you bump into, will be the Minerals Council. Now, you won't see a sign saying Minerals Council of Australia. In fact, you're likely to be arrested if you go in there. Government building and all that. These guys really have the game sewn up. But there's quite a funny story because Rupert Murdoch's News Corporation have been hammering GetUp because it's on the other side. They're the enemy, they're the lefties supporting the Green and the Labor causes. So it was chasing GetUp saying, you guys need to disclose your links. The government must force you to disclose your links with political parties in Australia. So GetUp sort of went on, yeah, all right, we'll disclose our links. And so they changed the rules. And when they changed the rules, all political campaigners, all entities involved in political campaigning then suddenly had to disclose. So there's a new layer of disclosure. They're called the political campaigners. So here we have a situation where there are these close ties between some of the biggest resources companies in the world, the coal exporters and so on, and the Australian government, both parties. We have pretty much a non-existent energy policy. China, Korea, Japan all have stipulated that they will go to net zero emissions by 2050, or in China's case, 2060. Australia still has no target, and we can put that down to the power of the resources lobby in this country. And on top of that, there's absolutely no plan for transition. The transition to renewable energy is happening regardless of your political persuasion, whether you believe that climate change is real or not. It is happening, and it's happening very quickly. Yet there are thousands of communities around this country waiting for it to happen with no plan for transition. The Minerals Council's central plan, of course, is to keep their dying industry alive. There's a lot of dollars swilling around here, and they will do what it takes. They will buy off every politician, their political parties, just to get the votes to nullify any sensible policy on climate change. There's no prizes for guessing when ScoMo walked into Parliament that day and waved around his lump of coal, his nicely lacquered lump of coal. There's no prizes for guessing where he got that lump of coal. Like this video if you'd like to see ScoMo bring an actual climate policy into Australian Parliament rather than a lump of coal. You might notice that we're back in the living room. We're out of the studio, back in the living room. There's a concrete truck outside. It's busy and noisy anyway with the dress shop downstairs. So if you'd like us to be able to afford to soundproof the studio to bring you higher quality content, then chip in $4 a month on Patreon.